getting connected in rural Canada can prove slow and bumpy. Only a 45-minute drive from Toronto, Marcia Harse sometimes has to set up her modem and laptop outside just to get to work.
Why should I have to pay anything more than my friends in the city? If they can get unlimited internet for under $100, why am I paying $180 for 100 gigs? And why does it still stink?
Her download rate is just a fraction of what the federal government deems broadband speed. Considered a basic service, but one unavailable to most rural Canadians. Just ask Brenda Adams, self-employed and living within Ottawa's city limits.
This is not an option. I think COVID, if it has done nothing else, has really emphasized the discrepancies.
So the timing of the government's funding announcement is likely no coincidence. Long considered a priority, but now all the more pressing amid the pandemic.
We're not going to stop until we connect every single household to this essential service.
To the $1 billion already pledged last year, Ottawa is investing an extra $750 million. The goal? To give 98% of Canadians access to high-speed internet by 2026 and everyone else by 2030. Some of the money intended to get more communities connected in just the next year.
It was something that groups like ours had asked for, and it's going to no doubt go a long ways towards bringing relief quickly.
On many First Nations, however, getting affordable broadband could take much longer, with the hardest to reach areas left without access for a decade yet.
That's going to mean Indigenous communities, and that's going to mean rural and remote communities who now, through COVID-19, need this connectivity.
Like a long country road, for many, the wait drags on. Thomas Dagg, CBC News, Toronto.